The second pick in the 1985 NBA draft goes to the Indiana Pacers. The horseshoe works. Basketball is back in New York City, my friend.
When they pulled the Knicks card that the Knicks had won the lottery, my mother went crazy and woke me up in the crib, as the story goes. And because she knew we were getting Patrick Ewing. And Patrick Ewing at that point was the best college basketball player at Georgetown University. So it was ingrained in me since I was born to be a huge basketball fan.
I'm as proud as I've ever been to name somebody a general manager.
Kobe? Oh, he's funny.
Kobe Altman. He does it all.
He's a new version of your GM.
He has a sort of a toughness to him, and I'll call it the Brooklyn in him.
No sleep till!
Brooklyn sort of made me who I am today. Growing up in that diverse neighborhood, you see sort of every walk of life, and it sort of develops you in a way to be able to have great interpersonal relationships with anybody. My mom raised me on her own. By seeing her work every single day and never asking for anything was a huge inspiration to me.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home.
He was always very aware of what was going on. I mean, at 3 years old, he had a true sense of what was happening.
I wanted to play basketball, and I remember playing up and down the hallways. I wouldn't be as passionate about basketball if it wasn't for her. She was a basketball junkie, and so she raised a basketball junkie.
And I still am.
As you grow up, you learn, I'm not good enough to play in the NBA, but what can I do to be a part of basketball? If I wasn't going to go to a major basketball college to play basketball, I want to go to the best academic school. Posse afforded me the opportunity to go to this unbelievable school.
He's an incredibly talented, smart person who graduates from one of our great partner schools, Middlebury College, and then goes on to be the general manager of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Hello.
What Middlebury gave me was a chance to become a great writer. I hated writing papers. But what it taught me was I have to make my argument, articulate my argument, back it up with data, and being able to support that conclusion, and this is why I think this.
Where I think Kobe is special and where I think the Posse Foundation really made a great decision in the way that they go about doing things is Kobe's special because whatever the message needs to be and the way you're going to hear it the best, that's what Kobe's able to do.
Posse's ultimate goal is to prepare the next generation of leaders.
Posse gave me that opportunity to go to Middlebury, which in turn gave me the tools. I didn't know at the time, but it gave me the tools that I use every single day.
The Cleveland Cavaliers and Boston Celtics have completed a blockbuster trade for the ages.
A monster day for general manager Kobe Altman. The Cavs effectively blow up the roster around LeBron James. My initial reaction was wow, followed by wow, wow, and wow.
Kobe did a heck of a job of understanding what our team needed.
Kobe Altman got rid of some of that junk he got rid of and get the players he got. A home run by him.
I don't think anybody's ever inherited a more difficult situation than he did from that standpoint. He handles adversity very well.
The general manager, Kobe, you know, after everything went down, I thanked him for, you know, putting me in a good position. And also I told him, you did one hell of a job.
Inside, you know, can get fragile at times. So, you know, you have to be that rock, that standard. And Kobe does a great job of doing that every single day.
What's going on?
I feel like I've known him from day one, and you know, he was built to be a general manager in the NBA. I mean, he's just so good with people. He's so good with the players, the coaches, all the way down to the, you know, our support staff.
You go way back. Best thing you ever say when you care. On your way out, on the way home.
When I think about the kind of Posse scholar that models what this mission is all about, I think about Kobe.
How are you?
How you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
He's able to transcend all walks of life.
He gives us hope. After I get done playing, if I want to be in this basketball world, I know that I may have a shot knowing that he got in that position.
He comes to the games, watching me. Whenever he comes, I was always playing great.
He's always been a supportive person no matter what you were doing.
He was always there for me when I first started.
I'm gonna look back at the moment that we were together in the stands when we knew we were going to win. And Kobe and Trent and I hugging each other, crying together, was really a powerful thing for me.
Middlebury Posse 2, forever.
I believe in Kobe, and I think he's going to be here for a long time doing great things.
I think he's the most incredible person in the world.